The heat-loving tonguefish, which is a type of flatfish, is the only known flatfish to inhabit the extreme environment of hydrothermal vents. They live close to sulfur pools that are hotter than the boiling point of water.
The flathead sole, another type of flatfish, is also known as the cigarette sole, or simply, cigarette paper.
Some flatfishes are amphidromous. Instead of moving between fresh and salt water, strictly for breeding purposes, like catadromous and anadromous fish, amphidromous fish migrate between the two for various reasons outside of mating.
In some flounder species, every individual of that species has its eyes on either the right or left side of the head as adults. For example, the witch is a right-eyed flounder.
Right-eyed flatfishes are called dextral, and left-eyed flatfishes are called sinistral. These terms also apply to snails who can be right or left shelled.
Starry flounder individuals have their eyes migrate to either side of their head. In waters around Japan, they're mostly left-eyed, but along California coasts, they're about equally separated between being left and right-eyed.
One genus of flatfishes get their name because they have stripes just like a zebra. Some of them produce toxins from glands at the bases of their dorsal and anal fins.
Of the nearly 800 described living flatfish species, only about 10 are strictly freshwater fish.
In some flatfish species, the dorsal fin actually begins before their eyes. It's sort of like it starts on the bridge of their nose.
While it might not seem likely, it's currently believed that some of the closest living relatives to flatfish are billfish, like marlins and swordfish.
You've also probably heard that flatfish babies are symmetrical. They swim fast, and an octopus mimics them. But if you weren't aware of these facts, you can learn all about them and more in our full flatfish episode. There's a card on screen you can click right now. Go ahead, click it. There's lots to learn. And thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.